This is Mrs. Paseka, and this is an example of how you might be asked to use the centroid theorem. We're told that BD is congruent to AD, so we'll mark that on here. That means that D is a midpoint. Also that AF and CF are congruent, so F must be a midpoint there. And CE and BE are congruent, so that also makes E a midpoint. That would mean then that these segments connecting vertex A to midpoint E, AE is a median. Also, connecting vertex B to midpoint F makes BF a median. And then segment CD from vertex C to midpoint D, that's a median. G is the midpoint of the medians, so that makes G a centroid. And by the centroid theorem, we know that G is two-thirds of the way from B all the way across to F. If BG is two-thirds of the distance, then GF is one-third of the distance. If GF is 4, and if GF is a third of BF, maybe we can figure out how long BF and BG must be. Let's plug in here what we know. GF is 4, and 4 is a third of the whole segment from B to F, one-third. If you want to get rid of the one-third, we can multiply both sides by 3. That would give us 12 over here. Let's see if this makes sense. BF, the whole segment from B to F, is 12. Is GF 4, is that a third of 12? Yes. That is one-third of 12. 12 divided by 3 is 4. So if GF is 4, how long is BG? Well, if we do 12 minus 4, that's how long BG is, so BG must be 8 units long. So we know BG, we know BF, and we also need to find X. Let's make a little formula here. BG, that we just said here, is 8 units long that we figured out using our fractions, but BG is also equal to 2X minus 15. I'm going to substitute 2x minus 15 here instead of bg. And let's solve for x. We can add 15 to the other side, that gets 23, and divide by 2, x is 11.5. So we have solved for x, we have solved for bg, and we've solved for bf. Fg is 4, that was given, so we've taken care of everything we need to solve for.